Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you a technique that is useful whenever you have calculation groups that replace the content of a measure, instead of just changing the filter context under which the measure is being computed. As an example, we are going to use Contoso. In Contoso, they have sales amount, and they can compute sales amount using the net price or the unit price. Now, depending on the price you use to compute the sales amount, of course the values will be different. But not only the sales amount will be different, all the calculations that are based on sales amount need to be changed too. So let's take a look at the report. Here I have slicing by brand, the cost, then the sales amount computed using the net price and the margin using the net price, which of course are different than the sales amount using the unit price and the margin using the unit price. I don't want to create one measure for each variations because now I have only two measures, but I might have a lot more. So what I want to do is something different. I want my user to be able to use a slicer. From the slicer, they will choose either the net price or the unit price as the base calculation, and all my measures will behave accordingly to the choice. So if I click on net price, you see that I'm seeing a sales amount using the net price and the margin is one of the net price. And when I click on unit price, both sales amount and margin change using the correct number. Instead of looking at how I solved it here immediately, I want to show you step by step the problems that you might encounter when you start working on such a model. So let me open a different Power BI file that contains, it does not contain the solution. Here I already created a calculation group, which I called price to use, it's here. Let me use tabular editor, so we take a look at the definition of the calculation groups. If I go to table, price to use, here we are. We have two calculation items. Net price does not use a selected measure. It completely replaces whatever the selected measure is with this calculation, which is a sum x over sales of quantity times net price. Unit price does the same, but it uses unit price instead of using the net price. So whatever measure I put in the report, it will be replaced with this calculation. And this is the first problem. Because if I use the calculation group as it is now in my report, when I select net price, look what happens. The entire report is changed with the value of the net price. The sales amount, the total cost, the margin, they are all showing the same calculation. And the same for the unit price. So a calculation item which is applied at the matrix level will replace all the measures. We need to check that we replace only sales amount. And that can be accomplished using a tabular editor. I can go here and add an if statement that says if is a selected measure sales amount, then I compute my expression. Otherwise, I just call selected measure. Doing it this way, my hope is that the application will happen only for the sales amount. And once I do it for the unit price, I need to repeat the code for the net price, just changing unit price with net price. I can now confirm everything, apply the calculation item, apply the modification. So I save everything. And now you see that when I click on net price, I see the sales amount, total cost is fine, and the margin is correct. But look what happens if I select unit price. The sales amount changes, but the margin does not. So what is happening here is that my application happens only for the sales amount, but not for the margin. That's a problem. And to understand the reason, we need to inspect the query which is being generated by the report. So let me enable the performance analyzer. We start recording, refresh the visual, because I want to take the code of the matrix, which we then analyze in DAX Studio. Using DAX Studio, I can now inspect the code of my query and understand better where the problem is. Now, this query applies a filter to the calculation group, and then it uses summarize column. The filter is being applied here. So the application of the calculation item happens here for the sales margin. And what happens? What is selected measure when the application happens? The selected measure is sales margin percentage. The application happens, and if I look at the code of my calculation group, it behaves correctly. It checks if the selected measure is sales amount, then does the transformation. But it happens that the selected measure is not sales amount, it's margin percentage. So the if takes the else branch. In the else branch, it uses selected measure, and at this point, the application stops and never will happen again. The calculation group has been applied, margin percentage has been replaced with margin percentage itself, and the application will no longer happen. Now, the thing is, I want to control where the application happens. Let's go back to DAX Studio. If I look at the code of margin percentage, let's define margin percentage as a measure, you see that margin percentage does some calculations, and among the many calculations, it calls sales amount. This is where I want the application to happen. I don't want the application of the calculation item to happen here. I want it to happen here. I can do that. I can use calculate to force the application of a calculation item. But I also need to be sure that the calculation item has not been applied earlier, because a calculation item can be applied only once. Therefore, in order to solve the problem, what I need to do is to decouple the selection of the user, which happens on a different table. I will create a separate table so that the user chooses which price to use with a different table, and that table will drive the application of the calculation item exactly where I want it. So, now that the idea is clear, let's see how I solved it. Let's go back to the final solution. Okay, this is already the correct solution. What I did are two things. First, I created a disconnected table internal price to use. I did a disconnected table price to use. Price to use is no longer the calculation group. It's just a table and it's not a calculation group. I renamed the calculation group as internal price to use. Not only I renamed it, I also hid it so that a user has no easy way to use it in a report. Price to use is nothing but a copy of internal price to use. So if we look at the code of price to use, it is just using select columns to grab the values of the calculation group and store them into a table that is completely disconnected from the report. Based on that, in my report, I have the slicer. This slicer is no longer connected with the calculation group. Instead, it is connected with the disconnected table. When a user clicks on any of these items in the slicer, nothing is going to happen at the report level. But in my code, I will be able to intercept that value and move it as a filter for the calculation group. And that's exactly what I do in sales amount. The current version of sales amount is different. This version of sales amount calls internal sales amount. Internal sales amount is the original definition of sales amount. My sales amount calls the internal sales amount and uses treat as to read the content of the disconnected table and treat it as a calculation item. So this treat as takes the selection on the disconnected table and move it as a filter for the calculation item. Now, this is when the calculation when the application of the calculation item happens, and I can control that. What is the code of margin percentage? Well, margin percentage didn't change. Margin percentage just calls sales amount. By calling sales amount, it will drive the application of the calculation item exactly where I want. And the net effect of all this is that from the user point of view, the experience is just smooth. When I select net price, I have a calculation based on the net price, and when I select unit price, my calculation is based on the unit price. As you have seen, calculation groups are extremely powerful. They give you an easy way to inject parameters inside your calculation. But if you not only want to change one measure, but you want an entire tree of calculation to change the behavior based on that parameter, you need to pay attention to when the application of the calculation item happens. If you are interested in this topic, I suggest you to first go to SQL BI and read the full article that goes into some interesting details. And if you are not yet used to calculation groups, we have a series of articles that explain all the details that you might need to know about calculation groups. They are a very powerful and quite complex features, so take your time to learn them the right way before using. And with that said, enjoy DAX!